With gender mainstreaming serving as a key component for women's rights advocacy, women are working to ensure full coverage in the Gambia's new constitution. This retreat assembling women delegates seeks to emerge with a gender position paper for consideration by the Constitutional Review Commission. Amid efforts to increase women representation and engagement in key positions of governance, advocacy groups say much more still needs to be done, and despite women constituting 51% of the population, they are continuously outnumbered by men in the realm of power. The Minister of Basic and Secondary Education, Claudia Nicole, said women representation at the highest level of decision-making remains a major concern.
The women are the most discriminated and least represented at decision-making positions. Therefore, this consultation is both timely and relevant towards achieving the national goals and the priorities of our nation.
Cole urged participants to design a number of parliamentary seats for women in the National Assembly. The executive director of the Women's Bureau, Fanta Baiseka, noted that participants will look at key areas that are major concerns impeding women's development.
We're looking at issues of citizenship, we're looking at issues of inheritance, issue of land access to women, we're looking at issues of education as well, we're looking at issues of women's health and the challenges, we're looking at representation of women in the district tribunals.
She further revealed that women are currently expressing interest in vying for positions that no woman has ever occupied in the Gambia.
You'll notice that Gambia has no woman chief, right? I hope we will soon have, because two strong women have applied for chieftaincy, and I hope the government will certainly consider them.
The Secretary General of the Constitutional Review Commission, Omar Ojoub, said the development of a gender position paper for the ongoing Constitutional Review Commission's issue document is in line with the strategic objectives of the CRC. He assured the Bureau that the CRC will uphold to its principles of participation, inclusiveness, transparency and ownership to achieve its mandate. Dilating on the need for effective democracy to implementing women's voices, the representative of the United Nations Development Programme, Emily Sarr, says it's highly imperative to consider the needs of women in the plan in order for the new constitution to achieve its strategy goals.
I would like to assure you that UNDP remains true to its mandate in support of good governance and ending poverty with a principle determined to leave no one behind. Agenda 2030 and the SDGs have the potential to make a real difference for gender equality and women's empowerment.
The chairperson of the National Women Council, Ami Fabori, said the participation of CSOs has been intensified to the call for gender parity. She outlined insufficient resources as a key challenge to implementing the activities and hailed the existing partnership with the UNDP as a vital collaboration strengthening empowerment programs. The introduction of the new constitution will set the motion for the dawn of a third republic where women foresee more representation and engagement in key positions both within the executive, legislature, and judicial systems. For the news, I am Sisi Sawane.